In this video, I will talk about some of the signs that will help you identify if someone is a victim of human trafficking and modern slavery. So let's get right into today's video. Hi and welcome to FinCrime Agent, my YouTube channel talking about financial crime and anti-money laundering related topics. If you haven't subscribed yet, please hit the subscribe button below and press the bell so you can get notified once new videos are going live on a weekly basis. Also, check the description of this video where I'm putting interesting links and references for the topics that I'm covering in my videos. Also, in the description of this video, you can find the link to the patreon.com page for FinCrime Agent, where you can support my project with a small contribution and receive some unique material created for my patrons. With this video, I'm continuing the discussion about human trafficking and modern slavery that I already started in another video where I'm talking about the size of human trafficking and modern slavery. If you want to watch that video, you can find it in the link right above and find out more about the size of this global issue affecting huge amounts of people globally. The objective of today's video is not to make you extra paranoid about the society, but it's more to make you more informed about those signs and in case during your daily life you will see something that doesn't look right, you are in the position to identify those signs and then make your reporting. So let's get right into today's video and talk about those signs, which are in line with the Modern Slavery Helpline, and the link of this website you can again find in the description of the video. As always, I have prepared some slides, so let's bring up the slides and talk about the first sign. The first sign is one of the most obvious, is about the physical appearance on those victims of human trafficking and modern slavery. They usually could display signs of physical or physiological violence. They tend to be malnourished or unkempt. In terms of their behavior, they will show signs of anxiety, and they are generally very agitated or even with a withdrawal attitude and feeling of being ignored. In some cases, they may also show some injuries which have been untreated. So those are easy to identify, and if you see someone with this type of characteristics, they could be victims of human trafficking and modern slavery. The second sign that I want to highlight is the sign of isolation. They are rarely permitted to travel on their own, for example, and tend to be under the authority or from under the influence of others. You can see that they will rarely communicate, and they seem generally unfamiliar with the community that is around them and how they generally function within the community. In some cases, there could be also a strange relationship taking place. For example, there could be a young teenager that seems to be the boyfriend or a girlfriend of someone that is much older. The third sign is about difficult living conditions. Those people that are affected by human trafficking and slavery, they would probably tend to be living in overcrowded places, or for example, they could work and live in the same location, or sometimes those locations can be overcrowded, so multiple people living in the same place. So if you spot some locations that can resonate to you in this description, this would probably raise a bell and therefore make you concerned if someone is a victim of human trafficking or modern slavery. The fourth sign that I want to list is the restricted freedom of movements. Those victims have no identity card often and hardly any personal belonging. Usually you can see that they would wear the same clothes day after day at all times, and probably the clothes that they are wearing is not fit for the job that they are doing. Possibly they have no chance to move freely and may have restrained in their travel paper. For example, they won't have a visa or a passport to move within the country or internationally. The fifth sign is about their unusual travel times. You can see that those victims would be either really early or late at night to be dropped off or picked up from their place of work on a daily basis. There may be someone who's picking them up and dropping them at very unusual times. The sixth and last point that I want to list is victims will be reluctant of seeking for help. They will try to avoid eye contact. They generally seem afraid or unwilling to chat to stranger and distrust the law enforcers. So this is one last sign that is also important. If you see someone that is within this type of behavior, this could be a sign of slavery and human trafficking. This is not a full list, but this is just a guide that should make you more aware about some potential signs to spot these crimes within the society. Should that be the case, that any of these signs in people around you or in the area where you live would make you concerned, what you should do is make your own reporting to the Modern Slavery Helpline. In the UK, you can call the 08000 121 700 or you can call the police on 101. In case of an emergency, always call 999 in order to make your reporting to the police. The same message that I've left in my other video regarding to modern slavery and human trafficking is don't leave it to someone else. Do your part to bring down this problem and do your reporting, because with one reporting you could save someone else's life. With that, I'm at the end of this video. I wanted to list some of those signs, which is not the full list, but I hope it's going to give you a sense of direction and inform you a little bit more regarding those victims. If this video was useful and you think someone else can benefit from this type of information, please share my video with your contacts. And if you want to find out more about future videos, remember to subscribe to FinCrime Agent and press the bell so you can get notified once new videos are going live on my channel. I hope you have enjoyed my contents and thank you for watching. Until next time, see you soon.